Ladies and gentlemen, it's that time of year again. Double Dip December! I'm Darkest101 and welcome to another season of Double Dip December. The beginning of December. A season of goodwill toward men. All the joys of Christmas. And what better way to start off this merry season with a game about the big red man himself. See, but I know you think that, but no, it's not him. It's not him either. Okay, first of all, I said big.
Hellboy. Published by Dark Horse Comics, Hellboy revolves around the eponymous demon character who is pretty much what you'd get if you somehow managed to fuse Ghost Rider, Captain America, and Batman. To be perfectly honest, I never read the comics, didn't even know there was an animated series made of this, and definitely didn't know about this little gem of a video game we'll be talking about today, Hellboy, The Science of Evil. Hellboy, The Science of Evil was based off the two Hellboy movies by Guillermo del Toro. I say it was based off the two movies because, while technically it's based on the first Hellboy movie, this game could have served as an advertisement for the second as it came out a month before the Golden Army. Somehow that doesn't build confidence. I've always been a fan of the Guillermo del Toro Hellboy movies. Hellboy and Hellboy 2, The Golden Army, were some pretty awesome movies in my opinion, and some pretty badass entries into the world of Hellboy for those who had never read them before. Also, Karl Cronin is one of the best badass secondary antagonists in a movie. The movies, in my opinion, were really good. I thought they were great. So, a game based on the movies sounds like a brilliant idea. I mean, I was actually surprised. I hadn't heard about this game until you guys mentioned it to me, so I was genuinely expecting some sort of hidden gem of the PlayStation 3. Not what I got. I don't know exactly what I was expecting when I put this game into my PS3, but what came out was a confusing mess of controls and Ron Perlman putting less shits into his performance than, I don't know, less shits than YouTube gives about the small-time YouTubers when compared to the corporate monsters that can call bullshit whenever they want. I'm still kind of salty about that, YouTube, as you could probably guess. This is war. First off, you know your game is bad when, for no reason whatsoever, and this wasn't me just being an idiot by the way, this wasn't a dumb mistake or anything I did, when I started playing this game, the brightness was at its absolute lowest. Not even kidding. The actual in-game brightness of this game, brand new, in my PS3, was at its rock fucking bottom. Although me stumbling around in the dark for 10 minutes was kinda my fault. What isn't my fault, however, is getting stuck fucking twice in level fucking 2. And this isn't because I was being stupid or anything, no, I know exactly why I kept getting stuck on this son bitch. You see, this game has this weird thing where it relies on Hellboy using weapons he picks up from his enemies to pass through the levels. Now, this would be fine if, for instance, the weapons stayed around after you beat the enemy in question. Thing is, they don't. You have to perform a grab finisher with a grab mechanic that barely functions, by the way, when the enemy is at a low enough health, but not so low enough that he dies in one fucking hit, so you can get the one weapon from one of the three types of enemies currently trying to kick the shit out of you, only one of which holding the weapon you need, and if you accidentally finish off all the enemies, you are fucking stuck. Now when I say you get stuck, you literally get stuck. You can't even go back. You are just trapped in this one little area in which nothing happens. You are fixed. No new enemies spawn, no game over screen pops up, no fucking weapons just drop out of nowhere to help you. You're just in that one place. If you finish off the last enemy with the weapon you need to advance, you might as well just quit the game and restart. Seriously. And I mentioned how the grab mechanics barely function. The hitboxes of these enemies for the melee are so fucking precise that half of your attacks are always going to miss. It doesn't help that Hellboy is slower than one of Frieza's minutes, and it certainly doesn't help that some enemies in the game look exactly like Hellboy. Not even fucking kidding. At one point, one of the enemies looked so similar to Hellboy, I was genuinely convinced I was playing as it, and was wondering why he wasn't responding to my input until I realised that Hellboy was running into a fucking wall. And this game setting is... it's just weird. I mean, I haven't read any of the Hellboy comics. I'll put my hands to admit that, just so you know. But this game was adapted from the movies. And the movies were freaking set in civilization. Or at the very least, they started there. Okay, let me show you what I mean by this, alright? Let's fucking time how quickly you get lost in this game. The game literally just opens up with Hellboy running through some woods. And already lost. Wonder how long that was? 3.25 seconds. It took just over 3 seconds for me to be fucking lost with the plot of this game. The fuck? Question 1. Where the fuck are we? Question 2. The fuck are we doing here? Question 3. Why the fuck are we in some random ass woods instead of in the US? Just to clarify for you, right from the pop, we have 3 of the 5 basic elements of storytelling missing. The shit is wrong with this game. Look, I know that sometimes you want to grab the attention of the audience by throwing them into a situation, but this is a game about Hellboy based on the movies. The movies didn't start without at least throwing in some fucking backstory about what the fuck the movie was going to be about. With the movies that this piece of shit game proclaims to be based on, there was some sort of setup, a prologue, a preamble, a fucking John Hurt narration. Anything! The setting is really fucking weird as well. We're in a graveyard for the first mission, a graveyard in Romania. A graveyard in Romania populated by supernatural motherfuckery. Hellboy works for the BPRD, for fuck's sake. There are other agents, other people in the universe he could talk to, so why are we given no backstory, no explanation, no mission briefing? We're the fucking players. We're the ones who need to know the information most, and yet Ron Perlman's the only one who speaks throughout the entirety of the first mission. Did he just cheap out and only pay for Ron Perlman to read their shitty script? Because that genuinely looks like a possibility. Hellboy ends up chasing what we discover to be a witch through the graveyard, coming across these weird little golem things. And then suddenly werewolves appear. Really? There are werewolves in this game. One of the biggest movie monsters of all time. And you didn't think to give them some sort of introduction? Some sort of, I don't know, an explanation as to what they were, what their weaknesses was? Because I know you have Doug Jones on your roster. So he could have been, Hellboy's voice in Hellboy's ear. The little earpiece telling him information about what the hell's going on. Like he does in a fucking movie. But no. You just strapped him into the shitty ass multiplayer, which I'm sure is fucking fantastic, by the way. Let me tell you. When you could have made him the game's Navi. Anyway, a lot of boring melee combat happens, blah blah blah. And then Hellboy comes across a village in a valley. And then he's punched by Psycho Mantis for some reason. You know when people say, I'ma punch you into next week? The game makes it look here that Hellboy has genuinely been punched back to 1982. And not only back to 1982, but 1982 in Japan. Like, no warning whatsoever. It's just, hi, we're in Japan now. Break out the sake and the jiggle physics, because we're going to make some hentai. Now, I can hear all of you crying out for an answer to the question, why the fuck are we in Japan?
Oh, that's cute. You actually think this game's going to answer your questions. Like, it gives a shit about the player.
And remember how I told you that I got stuck twice on this level? Well, that was kind of a lie because I got stuck the third time, but not because I accidentally finished off the last of the enemies with the weapon I needed to advance the fucking plot, but because the enemy itself didn't even spawn.
I wish I could tell you I was joking. I wish I could tell you that... I wish I could tell you that I was stupid. But no. He genuinely didn't spawn.
I didn't realise the fact that I was using the wrong weapon, because when Hellboy uses any of the weapons he picks up from an enemy, it sets itself on fire, looking just like the weapon you need to get through to the next area, except that the game decided Hellboy's fire isn't quite the same as a fucking spear with a lantern on the end of it for some reason.
And this, ladies and gentlemen, is where I just gave up with this piece of shit.
From the get-go, this game felt like no one gave a shit about how the fuck it was gonna turn out in the end. The melee combat is slow, sluggish, and repetitive, the level design is bland, uninteresting, and just loops over and over again, and the game is just fucking broken. They made no effort to get me invested in the story, and I can honestly say I don't think any story at all, could actually make this game any better, and I don't see the gameplay getting more enjoyable either.
The fact that Ron Perlman himself couldn't give a shit if his performance was any good or not should have told me just how pathetic this game was. It's repetitive, unimaginative, unimpressive, uninspired, and just plain broken. This was a shitty cash grab by publishers who pawned it off to inexperienced developers because they just couldn't give any fuck about it whatsoever. Want to know why I know this? Because fuck you, Konami! This game gets a dark rating of 18. Screw this! Well then, Double Dip December's off to a great start. First game gets a dark rating of less than 20. Not a good sign. But stick around for about an hour or so. I'm pretty sure we'll have something a little better on the way round. I've been Darkest101, and thank you for tuning in to the first review of Double Dip December. Thanks for watching. Good night, YouTube.